no secret that in order for your app to be successful, the user has to run it. And for it to continue to provide value, sometimes it needs to keep running. But this is tough to do when the phone is asleep. I mean, what are you going to do? Wake up the phone and do the work even though it's already sleeping? Well, yes, of course, but be careful here because there's a large battery problem waiting to happen. My name is Colt McAnlis, and disturbing your phone's beauty sleep is one of the biggest causes of unneeded battery drain on Android. But with a few simple changes to how you're working, you can achieve the same result with less battery problems. To illustrate this point, let's talk about my good friend Rado. He's an avid social user and a game player, which means his running applications are constantly checking scoreboards, uploading photos, and pulling down the latest hashtag crazes. But they do this even when Rado has put his phone to sleep, which means by lunch, his phone's already out of battery. Rado has to constantly recharge his phone because it suffers from sleep deprivation. That is, because these applications are constantly waking up the phone, they're eating up battery life instead of letting his phone sleep. And sleep is important. Remember that Android will turn off various parts of your hardware in order to prolong battery life. First, the screen will dim, followed by it eventually turning off, and finally the CPU will go to sleep, all in an attempt to save precious, precious battery. But even in this inactive state, most apps will try to do work, and they will have to wake up the phone to do so. Now, the easiest way for an app to wake up your phone to do work is with the PowerManager.WakeLock API, which is used to keep the CPU running and prevent the screen from dimming or turning off. This allows your phone to do things like wake up at some future point, do some work, and then let the phone go back to sleep. But see, it's that last part that's the tricky one. See, acquiring a wake lock is actually really easy, but knowing how to release it is more problematic. There's lots of ways that this can go horribly wrong. What if your application takes 60 minutes instead of the expected 10 seconds it takes to analyze some image before uploading it to the server? Or what if the server crashes and you never get a response from your social media ping and you end up waiting forever for a result? The end result is the phone never sleeps and chews through your battery, which is exactly why you should be using the version of wakelock.acquire that takes a timeout parameter. This will force the wake lock to be released after a certain amount of time, just in case one of these edge cases actually happens. But this won't actually solve the problem fully. I mean, what should you set the timeout value to be? Or how long should you wait before trying to do it again in case you actually failed the first time? The right solution to this might be to use inexact timers. See, normally you set some future date for your event to kick off and wake up the phone, but it might be better to change that timing in order to conserve battery. For example, if there's another application that needs to wake up 5 minutes after yours has requested to, it's optimal to wait for that one to happen so that you can bundle the work together. This is at the core of what inexact timers do. You can schedule some work for the future, but if the system detects that there's a better time, it can delay your work in order to save battery. And in reality, there's a whole group of other situations that might be better to do battery-intensive work. For example, when the phone is charging or connected to Wi-Fi or already woken up by another process. If any of your work can be deferred to a future date when these conditions might be ideal, then you can help improve battery life significantly. And this is exactly what the Job Scheduler API is for. See, this API is perfect to schedule some future work to wait for various combinations of these better conditions. For example, waiting until the unit is plugged in, waiting until you're on Wi-Fi, or batching a bunch of these tasks together at once. Basically, with one simple API, you get all that scheduling for free. And don't forget, with the new revamped battery usage details on the phone, users now have the ability to see how long your app is keeping their phone awake for, and even have the ability to uninstall it right from the same screen. Which means you should probably take a few extra minutes and make sure that all of your wake lock logic is in order using the Battery Historian tool. This tool rolled out with the L release of Android and can help you understand how often wakes are kicked off, who initialized them, and how long they lasted, all in a nice visual package. With these new tools and APIs, you can finally give that sleep-deprived phone some well-deserved rest. But of course, if you would like to avoid sleeping, then check out the rest of the Android Performance Patterns resources. And don't forget to join our Google Plus community as well. So keep calm, profile your code, and always remember, perf matters.